Hello, friends, and welcome to Encouragement for Today. Rays of hope to carry us through these dark times of unrest. And there's no better place to find that ray of hope than in the light of God's holy and precious Word. Let me invite you today to pick up your copy of God's Word, your Bible, and turn with me to the third chapter of the book of Ephesians. I want us to begin our reading today over in about verse number 14, and we'll go through verse number 21 as our text verses of Scripture. And I want to bring to you a thought that I've titled, Understanding God's Love. Now, what we'll do today is we'll read this prayer that Paul prayed for the Ephesian people. Notice the words. For this cause, I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with his mighty spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, and that ye being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and depth and height, and to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us, unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. What a powerful prayer that we see here. But now the greatest thing that I see in all of this is that as much as I try to explain to you God's marvelous and wonderful love, friend, it is indescribable. It's just something that you have to experience for yourself. When we look at this powerful prayer that Paul prayed here, first of all, we find him bowing on his knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I always tell people, if at all possible, it don't hurt to get down on your knees. In the little church that I pastor, we still have prayer altars, and we have cushions over the altars so that it might help the knees just a little bit. But we always invite people to come and bow at the altar of God. Now, you need to know and you need to understand that there are some that just can't bow because of their physical ailments and the things that's going on in their bodies. But friend, if you're bowing in your heart, you're on your knees. Because I bow on my knees unto the Father. And then he mentions about the family of God and that God would grant them riches to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man. Friend, we need the strength of God to go through these dark times, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, being rooted and grounded in his love. Friend, we need to be rooted and grounded in the love of God. And then he talks about being able to comprehend with all the saints the breadth, the length, the depth, the height, the measure of God's marvelous love, and to know the love of Christ, listen, that passes knowledge. I've been preaching the love of the Lord Jesus Christ for over 40 years, and it's an indescribable love. You know, whenever we begin to think about God's love, it's so great that we as mere human beings just cannot fully understand it. Humans' loves for one another often depends on at least partly on the behavior that that person is doing, the one that's being loved. But God's love for us doesn't depend on that. He loves us in spite of ourselves. Do you long to know and be loved by God? God is the only one who can truly love in that manner. I mean, I look at the way some of the people are acting in this old world today, and it's hard to love them, but God loves them in spite of their self. Then I look at the actions of my own life and the things that I did in my life. And I know some of you probably looking at me real spiritual right now, like you don't have anything in your closets. But friend, if you look in your closet, there are probably skeletons in all of our closets, because the Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. God loved me in spite of myself, and I'm so thankful that He did. For 40 years, I've been trying to explain this love to everybody. But friend, it's something that can't be explained. It's something that's got to be experienced. You need to experience the love of God. And if you experience the love of God, friend, I'm going to tell you, He'll give to you peace that passes understanding. And He'll carry you and light up this old dark world that you're living in. He'll carry you through this world, light it up for His glory. Now, I love verse 20, where the Bible says, "Unto Him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think." My friend, He's able to do more, and He gives more than enough. Your cup will run over according to the power that worketh in us. Unto Him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. To God be the glory. Great things He can and will and has done in our lives. Friend, I don't know about you, but God's love is just, it's hard to understand how somebody could love you in spite of yourself. Friend, even when you don't love Him, He still loves you. Probably the most passionate and powerful scripture in all of the Bible is John 3:16, where the Bible says, "For God so loved the world." I tell people all the time, take the word "world" out right there and write your name in. Amen. "For God so loved you that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have." Hallelujah. I like that, "but have." You know, a lot of times in life, whenever you hear somebody say, "Well, you know, I love you, but," you better look out for what's coming next. But friend, I love that word "but" here. "He that believes in the Lord, but have everlasting life." That's how much God loves you. He wants you to have everlasting life. But you see, it depends on you. Will you come to Him? Will you get to know Him personally? Will you experience His love? If you'll do that, my friend, He'll give to you everlasting life. Wasn't it good to be loved by somebody that loves you that much, that's just willing to give you everything that He's got to give? In fact, He did. He gave His very life on the cross of Calvary so that you could live. Think about that. Let's pray together. Father, we thank You for Your love, a love that really can't be comprehended in human terms. But oh, when we look at it through the spiritual eyes of the Lord Jesus, God, how wonderful it is. I'm so thankful that I've experienced Your love. And I pray for the one that needs to experience it most now, that they'll get to know You personally. In Jesus' name. Amen. Well, friend, I don't know about you, but bless God, I find encouragement in these words today. And I pray that you do too. And listen, there's a lot of hurting people out there in this old world today. Try to encourage them in the Lord. I would ask that you all remember our Berrien County probate court judge. She lost a son yesterday, and I know that she's grief-stricken and that she's having a very hard time right now. May you pray that God would just let her experience the comfort and help that only He can give to her and her family during this sad time. And there are others hurting as well. So many people have lost loved ones through this pandemic, and I call it a plague. Through this old plague that's hit our land, many people have gone on to be with the Lord, standing before the Lord in judgment. And, you know, friend, there's hurting people out there, and you can encourage them today. May God bless you, keep you, cause His face to shine upon you, and let people see the light of Christ in your life. Have a great day.